الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون، إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا، اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا، وعلمنا ما ينفعنا، وزدنا علما نافعا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم. أستغفر الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله ربي من كل ذنب وأتوب إليك. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. My dear respected brothers and elders, it is a great opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enabled me and you to sit here. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire me words that becomes the means and the reason for the deliverance in the day of Qiyamah from the fire of Jahannam.
Ameen.
I have read a Quranic ayah, and this topic is a very common topic and a very important topic. You see, Allah ta'ala, when a child is born, naturally he has that instant knowledge. For example, a child, you don't need to teach him how to eat. You don't need to, when a child, when he's born, a baby, when he's born, when he's hungry, what does he do? He starts crying. And the mother gets the knowledge on top of her head, and she knows straight away that this child is trying to say he's hungry. So this is a natural knowledge that Allah has given. And there's many people who may be not lettered, maybe unlettered. You know, in the time of Rasulullah, lot of people was unlettered. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was unlettered. He was ummi, but he was the most knowledgeable from every human creation on the surface of earth. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Utiitul ilm al awwalin wal akhirin." I have been given the knowledge from the beginning of this time of this world until the last. Even though Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was ummi. Even though Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was ummi. So being unlettered, it doesn't mean this man is ignorant. He might have knowledge as well. Sometimes we see people who is qualified in college and university, and some people who is not even qualified, even he's doing better than the engineers. We do see this. So this is a natural instant knowledge sometimes Allah gives some people. But Allah says, وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ السَّمَعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. That when you, Allah has given you birth from your mother's womb, and He has gave you eyes, ears and heart, You see, these, there are five hawas. According to the ulama, they say, there is hawas khamsa, the five sense. And from these five places, we are learning by seeing, by listening, by speaking, by thinking, and by our heart. The hawas khamsa. But beyond that, there is another level where people has to spend and put their aql, put their intellect to find things, to find resources, to find solutions. But beyond that, the aql and this knowledge is the knowledge of deen, ulume nabuwat, the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when it comes to deeni religion knowledge, you cannot put birra'i. You cannot put your own opinion. You must consult and resort to an eminent scholar who has chain narration, who has the permission, who has the ijazah from his sheikh all the way to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For example, today, if you call a person a hafiz al-Quran, you literally, in today's day and age, we call him someone who has memorized the Quran. But in those days, you know who was the Hafiz of Quran? Those people who maybe knew hundreds of thousands of hadiths by heart. Those people who only memorized the Quran, they were called Hamil al-Quran. They were called Hamil al-Quran. They were called the carriers of the Quran. They were not called Hafiz al-Quran. The Hafiz al-Quran were those who memorized thousands and thousands of hundreds of hadiths of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, what I'm trying to say is that knowledge, it has come from stage to stage. So, like for example, today, if you become a hafiz, you must go and learn from a teacher. Nothing is learned without a teacher. If you learn without a teacher, your knowledge will be blessless. There will be no blessings in your knowledge. And if you learn knowledge without respect, your knowledge will be blessless. You will have no blessings in your knowledge. And because this deen and Islam, obviously, the deen and Islam has come through strife and struggle. Come through sacrifice of our aslaf, our salafi salihin, our mashayikh, our shuyukhs. They gave the sacrifice and today we are eating today. But in today's world, we see that the knowledge is there, ready on the plate, but there's no one there ready to eat the knowledge. You see the books in the libraries. You see many, many authors of books, writers of books, different hadith books, different fiqh books, different writers of different commentary on different books. It's all on the shelf. It's all on the shelf, but it's not in our heart. But in those days, you know, people, they used to have it in their heart. It was in their heads, but it was less on the shelf. One Hazrat Abu Dardas, he says that one person came to Hazrat Abu Darda and he said, I have not come to you. He traveled from Dimashq. He said, I have not come to you except for one reason, to narrate you a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first thing is, when a person makes the firm intention to acquire knowledge, man salaka tariqan lita'allum al-ilm sahhala Allah tariqan ila al-jannah. When a person makes the intention to acquire the knowledge of deen and Islam, the first thing is his door for Jannah had opened for him. And then it goes on the hadith. Do not ever, I'm saying in the member of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do not undermine the ulamas of deen. Do not undermine the ulamas of deen because wa inna al-ulama liyastaghfiru man fi as-samawati wal-ard wa hatta al-hut fi al-ma' wa hatta an-naml fi hujriha. That it says in the hadith that even the people of the skies and the people of the earth, they are making dua for them 24/7. They are making dua for them. They are making dua for them. Even so, even the creations in this oceans, even the fishes in the ocean, they're making dua. Even an-namlatu fi hujri, what is the smallest thing on the earth? The ant. So what is this hadith trying to say? That every creation is praying for the ulama-i deen to spread the deen, who are spreading the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They're not small, they haven't got small status, they're very big status in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A very big status. And then it carries on that وَإِنَّ الْعُلَمَا وَرَسَّةُ الْعَنْبِيَا. Today, naturally, when a person dies, our children, they become the inheritors. They take our wealth. Even though within this wealth, the brothers are fighting, the sisters are fighting, the uncles and aunties are fighting. When someone dies away, or sometimes someone even thinks that when is he going to die? I will get all this. Even someone thinks, when is he going to die? I'm going to get all this. But believe me, the ulamas, I was saying, do not ever undermine, because they are the waris, the inheritors of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. لَمْ يُوَرِّسُوا دِينَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمًا وَإِنَّ الْعُلَمَاءُ وَمَنْ أَخَذَهُ بِحَجْزٍ وَافِرٍ. So if you take a portion of this knowledge, if you take a portion of this knowledge, you have took a very big share, a great share in Islam. And Allah, believe me, understanding of deen, understanding of religion, understanding of Islam, Allah doesn't give everyone the same. If Allah has gave you the understanding of deen and give you hidayah, you should think that this is from my Rabb, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهَ بِهِ خَيْرٍ. If Allah intends to give someone good, give him the understanding of religion, خَيْرٍ, Allah says خَيْرٍ. يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ, then He gives him understanding of deen. What happens? He becomes worried about himself, he gets worried about his children, he gets worried about his community, he gets worried about the ummah, he gets the same fikr of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The zeal and concern of knowledge comes into him, and he starts trying to learn and acquire knowledge of deen.